We are about to investigate the secret to life. It's called DNA, and it's in every cell of every living thing, whether you're a bacteria or a human, from fungus to the tallest tree, any living thing at all, and it's very easy to get. First, you need to choose your living thing. I've chosen strawberries, but you could choose anything. You could choose wheat germ, you could choose chickpeas, you could choose pesky brothers and sisters, although they don't like being chucked in blenders, so you might want to avoid them. But today we've got strawberries, it's plants. Now, first thing though, you need a little bit of warm water, and you need to get some salt. Salt is your buffer. I've probably got about 2/3 of a teaspoon there. Dissolve that in your water. Now, for the strawberries. Chuck them in, bits of leafy bits and all. Keep enough strawberries in there so you get about half the amount of water as you've got strawberries. Get your blender. This just busts open the cell walls of a plant, assuming you've got a plant that is, but it busts open the cell walls for a start. That should do. Get it nice and pulpy. And you've just made a mess of your mum's kitchen, but that's okay. Now, dishwashing detergent, straight from the kitchen cupboard. This is very important stuff. And again, kitchen chemistry. And then amount of liquid, about 15-20 mil. And then you've got to gently swirl it. Now you should ask yourself, why are we adding dishwashing detergent? It's a very good question. Think about why you use soap on your hands to remove grease. Cell membranes, which contain all the DNA, are made of fats or lipids, okay? You add the dishwashing detergent to break down those cell membranes, which are made of fats, okay? Once those cell membranes are broken down, all the DNA spills out and it will then be swirling around in that liquid. That means we can get it out. Just gently agitate it. You want to avoid the froth. And then we wait for about 5 minutes. Gently swirling every 30 seconds or so. But did you know you share about 40% of your genes with the genes of a strawberry? That means you're 40% related to a strawberry. What you need to try and avoid is this froth. That's what you get if you swirl it too vigorously. It's easy to get rid of though. All you need to do is get a bit of paper towel, very carefully dab up that froth. The paper towel will soak it up and that removes it. It's just annoying a bit later on when you're trying to actually extract your DNA. Now we have to isolate the DNA. That's been sitting there and I've gently swirled it every now and then for about 5 minutes. So now we have to get our DNA out. And that requires a funnel like this, a bit of filter paper. You can use coffee paper, coffee filter if you've got one of those. You hold it in there and you just gently pour it in. And that will slowly filter out all the gunky bits and leaves and blobby bits that are in there. And what you should get through here is a nice, basically strawberry juice. But with all the cell walls busted open, all the cell membranes busted open, and DNA just floating all freely around in the liquid. And that means we can extract it. Okay, the filter paper works very slowly, so you might have to give it a bit of helping hand. Get your skewer, a gentle swirl, and that will help it move through the filter paper a bit quicker. Now, that takes a long time. If you're home in the kitchen, you don't have any of this sort of stuff, there's a very quick and simple way of speeding this process up. You need a bit of old open weave kitchen cloth like this, container of some sort, stick that in there, get your liquid again, strawberry juice, pour a bit in there, and just strain it through the cloth. Very carefully pick this up, slowly, you have to do it slow because otherwise it'll squirt everywhere, but gently strain it through your cloth. You don't get as pure a sample, but it does the job. Certainly if you push for time, this way works equally as well. Okay. And now we have to add our enzyme. Very simple, just meat tenderizer straight from the supermarket. And all this does is strip out a few of the proteins that are clinging to the DNA. Now I've only got 40 odd mil of strawberry juice here. Get about 1/4 teaspoon of meat tenderizer, put it in there, get your skewer again, and very, very gently stir in the meat tenderizer. Okay, the enzymes have done their job now, hopefully. So what you do, get yourself a little couple of test tubes. We'll use most of this. Pour it into your test tube, back in its rack. Now, the next step is to add alcohol. You can use methylated spirits, okay? I've got 95% ethyl alcohol here. Metho works just as well. Or rubbing alcohol, you can get that from a chemist. Little dropper. Now, the trick is here, is to make sure the alcohol forms a layer on top of the strawberry juice. bit like making a daiquiri, really. And you add about the same amount of alcohol as you've got strawberry juice in there. So tilt your tube a little bit, drizzle the alcohol down the side. Keep doing that. Now what will happen, the DNA is insoluble in the alcohol. It will move from the strawberry juice into the alcohol layer, and you'll see the DNA in the alcohol layer. It will be that very snotty cotton wool looking stuff. And the way you can get it out, because you can get it out, get some skewers, snap them in half. Best end to use to get it out is the furry end that you just broke, because that catches the DNA much, much better. And then slowly, this is a good sample. Look at all that. Now that is cool. That is the secret to life. All the instructions on how to build a strawberry are in that cotton wool, snotty looking stuff. And the longer you leave it, the more DNA will move into your alcohol layer. It's not a bad sample, actually.